In this tutorial, we will take a more detailed look at the Mapping tab. Let's add a generic flat screen from the Screens tab. And let's make it a little larger because we will be using two projectors. Let's now switch to the Mapping tab. We talked about how to add a projector in a different tutorial. We'll just choose one from the list and drag it into the workspace. Once we have done that, we will then just grab another one. So now we have two projectors in our 3D space. Let us activate the 3D grid now. Now we should go to the selection mode and choose projectors. Once you're dealing with more complex projects, it's pretty convenient to be able to select different categories individually like this, so you're able to select only projectors or only screens in the 3D environment. Moving the projectors follows the same principles you already encountered when dealing with screens and displays. You can move it and turn it manually, but you could also use the Inspector tab on the right side of your interface. Okay, so now we have the two projectors ready. We could now align the projectors manually, or we could use our auto-align feature, which works in the following way. You select both projectors and go to Open Auto Transform Editor. Once you've done that, you'll be presented with some new options. You could, for example, directly set up the soft edge area here. Let's say we want a 15% overlap. And we want our projectors to be aligned horizontally. So that would mean a setting of 2 horizontal and 1 vertical. Once you apply these settings, Pixera will automatically arrange the projectors in relation to the screen. The lines coming from the projectors just show which part of the screen the projector sees. They are an indicator for the optimized feed area feature, which will be explained in another tutorial. You can also let the labels show, which you can rename in order for it to better fit your style of organizing your projects. Let's say one is projector left and one is projector right. Alternatively, you can see both projectors in your project tab where you can switch between the two. Allocating the outputs works in the following way. You select your projector. Then you go to Live System, where you can select your output for your device. So, right-click and then Assign Output to Selected Image Devices. In our case, we now get to see a pop-up box that tells us that the projector has an aspect ratio that is different from the display that is actually connected. We'll just press OK. Let's not forget that we can also decide to display a test pattern at this point, like we did in one of the previous tutorials. Another important question is how to really make the outputs active. We can do this in two ways, either by using shortcuts or by using buttons. You can find buttons here at the bottom left. The middle one is Activate All Assigned Outputs, which would be F5 for activating or opening the outputs. The next button allows you to deactivate the assigned outputs, which can also be done by pressing Shift and Escape. To the left, we can also find the on-screen statistics, which means that once we've activated the render engine, so to speak, you can also display it on the outputs. These statistics show you current information like sync groups, drop frames, refresh rate of the output, and the current reading data rate of the hard drive.